Hello and welcome to this third tutorial video on how to make a jointed teddy bear. For this section of putting our bear together, we're going to be using backstitch again, so I'll make sure that pop-up's there so you can go get a refresher from our video tutorial on backstitch if you need it. We're going to trim our bear's muzzle. Now don't be daunted, your instruction booklet is going to give you really clear guidelines how to do this. We need the three sections of the head. That's the two side pieces and the head gusset. And let's start off with one of the head sides. If we lay it flat, you can see where the booklet suggests we trim. It's kind of a nice curve where the top of the head comes around and then takes an angle out across the top of the muzzle. Start at the tip of the muzzle in a technique that's almost the opposite of the way you cut mohair. So that's take the blades of your scissors, lay them flat against the backing and trim just the pile. Be careful not to catch the backing fabric because you don't want holes. And that's what will happen if you catch that backing fabric, you'll cause a hole in your bear's muzzle. So layer by layer, trim back. And the reason we trim back like this and the reason we don't look at the line of where our trimming is going to end here at the middle and plow through the middle is that you wouldn't be able to see that line where the pile is, and you might find yourself trimming too far back. And once this mohair has gone, it's not coming back. So here we are on the muzzle, we're going to trim across here again, starting at the tip of the muzzle, and we're going back to the point where again the gusset comes in and narrows as it goes towards the tip of the muzzle. So layer by layer, row by row, working your way back till it's roughly at that point. And it's always better to err on the side of caution. You can always come back and trim an extra bit. Don't worry too much at this point about it being too neat and too finished. We can take the tufts off later. Let's just get the area cleared first so we can see what we're working with. Now, there are two main reasons that we trim the muzzle, technical reasons at least. And those are, first of all, it makes the eyes and the nose and the mouth much easier to see. And the other reason is that if you trim the muzzle once you've sewn it together, you're going to have in the edges, you're going to have pile in the seam. And no matter how neatly you trim that, you're going to probably be able to see the ends of the tufts of the mohair. And you can pluck those out, but it's just that much easier and that much neater to trim them at this stage. If you know where you want it to be, of course, once you're an established bear artist and you're more confident, you might not know until you have bear's head together. You might want to sit with a finished bear's head and look at it and decide how you're going to change that bear's features by trimming it. Some artists at that point will still trim a section of the seam. I just like to decide here. And if I decide I'm going to alter it once it's together, I can. I'll just get the main sections cleared while my bear's head is in pieces like this. I think we're just about sorted on the gusset and this one side. I'm just taking a few bit of the extra tufts off, but I'll come back and finish it off completely in the end. And I'm just going to neaten it down. Because this mohair isn't too dense, there are almost clear rows of mohair for me to trim. The disadvantage, if you want to see it as a disadvantage, is this mohair has a bit of a wave. So even if I do trim a neat row, I might not get a neat straight edge, but I don't mind that. Okay, a little tiny bit more there. that's about done. I think that's about done. I don't want to go too far. Okay, just neatening. Now that I've trimmed the main area, I'm just taking a few of the tufts off just to neaten it. And then I can see that I've got that line straight. Take your time here. It takes me possibly for a quite simple trim like this about 10 or 15 minutes. And I'm going to just take off the same kind of area on the opposite side of the head. Just take the main part of it off first. It's very therapeutic, actually, this is. It's quite lovely, quite rewarding, sort of seeing this mohair fall away. And I do like bears with shaved muzzles. It's that lovely kind of old bear look where they have the shaved muzzles. It's really attractive. And it's quite a nice technique, very simple technique, and a very simple thing you can do to give your bear character is to shave the muzzle. With very dense mohairs, you can sculpt the mohair. You don't just take it back to the backing, you can actually cut it to different layers. But that's a little way up yet. Right, now we've got these two pieces. I'm going to just compare them and make sure they're roughly the same. Trimming off some of the worst bits here so I can just see it more clearly. And then I'm going to lay them together back to back and just make sure that the trimmed areas match up. I can see just by eye that bottom area isn't quite there yet. Right, let's have a look. So holding the tip of the nose together, tip of the muzzle, and this back of the head, bottom of the neck kind of area, line those up and then just see where that join is. See if that join is equal and alter it if it needs it. Just a few little tiny bits there just to make that match up. And then the same on the top. Line up. Make sure you've got the tip of the muzzle lined up. Just trim that bit there. And then it's really easy to see then that line matches. Again, it can be deceptive because of the curve in the mohair. Right. And then those last little tiny tufts and bits off. And it's worth doing this properly. It can look a bit like a bear with kind of a stubble shadow if you don't remove all of this neatly. And if that's not the look you're going for, make sure you trim it off properly. Sometimes if you curve the mohair around your finger a little bit, it'll stand up. You can curve the backing around your finger just a little bit and the mohair will stand up away from the backing and make it easier to trim. Let's have a look. If they match up. That's pretty good. And our head gusset is ready. So we're all ready for the next section, which is going to be inserting the ears. We've already cut an insert in the side of the head, and that's where we're going to position our ear, and a little bit will stick up over the top. I've got the ear inside out still to show you that there's a subtle difference in the shape. There's a slightly tighter curve at the top of the ear, and try to keep an eye on that when you turn the ear right side out, pulling the worst of the mohair out of the seam, but we won't worry too much. You can over sew these two edges together if you want to. Right, with the very bottom of the insert there, we've got the right side of the head and the right side of the ear, so the two furry sides together, and we're going to tuck the bottom of the ear right down into the bottom of the insert, and I'm going to fold it over so it's all the furry sides together. Keep that right down at the bottom, and you'll have four layers. You'll have the head on one side, you'll have the ear in the middle, it's almost like a sandwich, and you'll have the other side of the head. So there's four layers we're going through, we're pinning them in position, and it's important to pin this because it really will want to move about. I'm tucking a bit of mohair in just so we can see what we're doing, and then pinning it into position. And even on a bear that's not too big like this, I'm going to use three pins here because we can't afford to not catch the seam here. We've got to make sure our ear is well pinned in and that that's level, and then we're going to sew through all four layers right up to the top of the head, and we'll still have that bit of ear sticking up over the top. So through the four layers there, all the way up to the top of the head with a bit of ear sticking over the top, and we'll do that with the other ear as well. Now we've sewn the ears into the inserts up here, we're going to deal with the bit that's sticking up at the top, and that folds towards the tip of the muzzle, so it folds forwards along the line of the top of the head, and we're going to sew it and follow that line down there. So we'll pin it into position, and sew across that little bit there, and on the other one, pointing the other way because it's again pointing forwards towards the muzzle. I'm going to sew there, so pin it into position. It's always well anchored already up here, so it's going to go just across there, so it's a proper little right angle. Our ears are in our inserts, up there and across, up there and across towards the muzzle. And now we can start sewing the head together. We'll do that with the chin first of all. And we'll line it up and sew along this line. It's worth taking the time to tuck the mohair into the seam again as you pin this. Of course, you won't have any problem with the beginning of this because it's trimmed. But at the bottom here, tuck the mohair in while you line up the next definite point, which is the base of the chin, the bottom of the neck there. And then once that's done, you can fill in these gaps. Probably use two or three pins across here. There we go, and sew all the way along there to the tip of the muzzle. We've sewn up our chin under here, our ears are in the insert and pointing a little towards the muzzle, and now we can add the head gusset. There's a little mark at the tip there that lines up with the seam we've just created, So that little mark lines up exactly with the join in the seam. And it's important that you take your time to line this up as carefully as possible, because if this section isn't level, if this section is twisted, then the whole head, the whole muzzle is going to be twisted. So once you've got that in position, go right round to the back, take that next definite positioning point and pin that, tucking the mohair in. Pin it in place, and then let's look for this curve here where the curve of the muzzle shows up on both the head gusset and the side of the head, that curve. Line those up and pin that, and the rest of it we're going to have to do by eye. So let's put another one just here. That's our last definite point, and then little tiny sections that are flat and even. So tuck the ear in and the mohair in, and at this point we're going through four layers again, because we're going through the head gusset, the ear again, and the side of the head. And then let's go around to the back of the head a bit. Let's try and make sure it's level by doing a little area here and working back towards where we've gone. That's pinned in place. Next one. Just a few more should do this. There we go. I'm trying to keep these pins at kind of right angles. Then I'm trying not to angle them in too much. If they're going straight into the fabric without going at an angle, it's going to be easier for me to see if it's straight, if it's not twisted. I think I can fit another one in there. So we're going to sew all the way around there, catching the ear there, right the way around to the back of the neck. Let's start on the other side, so the back of the head, very, very back of the head where it meets the neck first, and pinned in place. And then that bend in the muzzle. Let's do the tip of the muzzle there first. Make sure we have that nice and tight. And then that bend. And then one halfway in between the two. Let's go around to the head and tuck that ear in. Tuck it right in. It's getting a bit crowded inside that head now with those two ears. Okay, tuck the mohair in. It's quite a thick area, that's where the ear bends around as well, in this position, this part of the head. And last one, I think. think I can get one more in. There we go. And let's have a look. Let's see if that looks pretty straight. And it does. It does. It doesn't seem to be puckered. It doesn't seem to be twisted. And we've got a notch in the exact right position at the start of the muzzle. So that's good. Let's get that sewn. That's fantastic. We have the five parts that are going to make our bear complete. We have the two legs with the foot pads in place and a decent sized gap at the back there for stuffing. The same here with the body. We're going to need to joint and stuff through that gap, and it's sewn all around. Head's done, sewn around with the insert in place. That muzzle looks nice and straight. And then we've got a gap at the bottom there for stuffing, and the two arms, paw pads in place, sewn all around with a gap at the back for stuffing. Let's have a look what it looks like the right way out. This is my favourite bit in a lot of ways. You start to see what your bear's really going to look like. If you have a problem with any of this, this is possibly the hardest bit because you're coming through quite a small hole. If it's hard to turn out, get a wooden spoon handle and use that. Something nice and curved, something not sharp. Let's tuck his muzzle through, pull his ears out. Oh, he's going to be lovely. Just push that right the way through. That's all nice and level. Let's have a look at an arm. Let's have a look and see what that paw pad fabric colour looks like against that mohair. That's nice. Yeah, pleased with that. And finally a leg. The first of the two legs. Because the foot's quite big, it's a little harder to push through. Sometimes you have to give it a pull, sometimes you have to get that wooden spoon and push it through. This is coming through okay. And then a bit that you really can't afford to miss, go around those seams, all of the seams, and pull out any stray bits of mohair that are stuck in there. It's one of those things that you can't really see as you're doing it, the difference it's making, but it makes a big effect, a big difference on the overall look of the finished bear. So take the time to do it on the head, particularly around the ears, where that will all be tucked in. Next time, we're going to joint and stuff our bear. We'll start off with the head, we'll join the arms, and we'll joint the legs, and then we'll stuff and close up the seams. I hope that's been useful. I'll see you next time. That concludes our tutorial video. I hope it's been helpful. If it has, please subscribe to the channel, give us some feedback and a like. There are more videos coming soon.